This woman is abused by her husband every day. Death is better than living. But until one day, she starts practicing boxing. Not long after, her boxing techniques have reached the professional level. This movie today will not let you down. It's called Enough. The main actress is Slim. And her husband is Mitch, whom she meets in a LA diner. That day, Mitch wards off a rude man trying to hit on her. They eventually marry and have a daughter named Gracie. That day, she still sees that her husband is smiling happily. 6 years later, she senses something wrong. This is the second time. She asks him that they have agreed with each other that they will live together forever. And said they will only love each other. She's so mad. You cannot do this to me. This slap makes her dumbfounded. She's never thought that the husband who's lived with her 6 years now smacks her. What? I can't hit you? No, you can't. Then he hits her to the ground. He threatens her that I make the money here. So I set the rules, right? He tells her to just stay at home and take good care of their daughter. Her eyes are filled with tears, she can't hold it. Before leaving, he even confidently tells her that it's how he is and then walks away. The next day, she goes to the police station to report domestic violence. But the policeman says once she has physical evidence of abuse on her person, they'll arrest him. And if he has money, he can bail himself out, which means he's free until it goes to trial. That also means that he may come after her once he's out on the street. Eventually, there is nothing that the police can do. She tells her friend everything that has just happened. So her friend makes her a plan. At midnight, when he's still sleeping, she silently wakes up, packs her stuff and runs away with her daughter. She holds her daughter and slowly goes out. But he immediately comes when she just opens the door. He grabs Slim's hair and kicks her in the stomach. Her friends who are waiting outside feel something wrong. So they run straight to the house with weapons. When they get in, Mitch is holding a gun. And Slim is beaten to faint on the ground. This man smartly holds his daughter up and tells her to look at her papa. Mitch doesn't want his daughter to have a bad impression on him, so he hides the gun behind. They both get out of the house successfully. She goes to the ATM and finds out that her bank account has been blocked by Mitch. So she can just afford a small hotel with her daughter. But as soon as she's got there, he calls her. And somebody is knocking on the door outside. She quickly picks her daughter up, runs away from the back door. And then gets on a bus. Luckily, he can't catch up with her. After running away, she makes an important decision. In order to escape from domestic abuse, she stays over at her ex-boyfriend's house. Her ex-boyfriend also feels happy. But suddenly there is a knock on the door. He goes to check. It's a man who calls himself FBI. Her ex-boyfriend is asked to open the door. Slim is hiding somewhere already. These people start rummaging from top to bottom. It's clear that they are hired by Mitch. They can't find Slim because she's hiding. Before leaving, they threaten her ex-boyfriend to be sincere and give him a phone. They even tear his sofa up. When Slim gets out, they receive a phone call. It's Mitch, her good husband. She doesn't want to keep putting people she loves in danger, so she decides to leave. She goes to a remote area, has her hair cut and starts a new life. But after a while, Gracie misses her dad. Slim doesn't want to take away her daughter's rights. So she drives to a phone booth to let her daughter talk to him. But she doesn't expect that Mitch uses his relationship to track down where the phone booth is. One day, when Slim is folding clothes at home, she's scared to death turning around. He gags her mouth and pushes her to the wall. And then strangles her. Their daughter hears that and runs outside. She holds his hair. And covers his eyes with her little hands. Slim takes this advantage to use the pepper spray on her watch to spray it directly to his eyes. And then she holds her daughter outside. She pulls the rope and Mitch is kept inside. Those are things that she has prepared to protect both of them. When just driving a little far away, Mitch's subordinate knocks on the car window. Slim is speechless when seeing this guy. This guy was the one that hit on her 6 years ago. So basically, everything was arranged by Mitch to pursue her. She then accelerates. And the black car is still chasing her. Slim crashes straight into the fence of a factory. And successfully cut him off. Not long after, she comes to a lawyer for the current problem. The lawyer says she ignored two chances to go to the police. Because it's mandatory to have wounds on the body if it's domestic violence. And Mitch is now suing for guardianship. But if she doesn't come to court, the judge would rule against her, and she'd become a fugitive. Which means that her daughter will be looked after by Mitch. But once she's there, her husband will portray her as a drug addict. The lawyer says that her attacker, Mitch, has a very good chance of gaining sole custody. So she's warned there is little she can do. If you can't stand it anymore, don't do it. She leaves her daughter with her friend. And decides to handle it herself first. Because of being abused all the time, she decides to learn boxing. She pays an eminent coach for teaching her. She's practicing non-stop every day, which considerably improves her strength. training her reaction speed by a ball, and practicing her hitting accuracy with the coach. She even asks him to strangle her to practice. This is the anger of a woman being abused by her husband, as well as the motivation for her to practice. She doesn't want to be a weak woman anymore. She has to be stronger and fight her damned fate. Over time, her eyes become more and more determined. In her eyes, you can see the overwhelming confidence. She feels that her small body has acquired the power to fight. Besides, she also knows that it's time to fight back. At night, she goes to Mitch's house, climbs over the fence easily, and breaks into his new home. After getting in, she carefully hides on the rooftop, and lies there for a whole night. Without Mitch knowing, he makes a phone call and then leaves. Once he's gone, she goes down by a bookshelf, takes her tools out from her bag. First of all, she breaks the phone line with a pair of pliers, and hides every metal things including knives and forks. Secondly, she detects his gun in the drawer and hides it. Next, she puts fake letters saying she is there to discuss custody of Gracie, and detects if there are any other guns in the room. Then tries to remember the arrangement of the furniture in the house, because she wants to make a big revenge. Putting on her boots, her rings that she's prepared, and her gloves to get ready and wait for him to come home. That night when he has got home, every light is off. He senses something wrong, so he immediately goes to get his gun. But the gun is not there, and he accidentally leaves his fingerprint on the letters. He starts calling people, but the line is cut. His mobile phone has lost signal as well. After that, she walks out. Mitch is happy to see her. He's even excited when she puts her hands up. Nothing can describe it. She steps forward and punches him in the face. And one more, he couldn't believe it. Next, her punch continues to hit him in the face. He pretends to turn around to hit her. But Slim immediately jumps downstairs. He follows her confidently. But he doesn't know that this is all part of Slim's plan. Slim punches him in his nose. When he attacks her, she moves away. Under Slim's provocation, he has turned the house into a mess. And left a lot of fingerprints. Technically, he's not her opponent. She just keeps driving him crazy. And using her words to stimulate him to make him strangle her. However, she smacks him constantly to his face and body. Then kicks him in the face with her knee. He can't fight anymore. She is about to smack him for the last time with a tray. But she can't. She walks upstairs and calls her friend that she can't do it. Because he is the one she used to love. But then she gets a smack behind. She trips him and remembers the time that she's abused. She remembers how he used to mistreat her. At this point, she doesn't care anymore. She kicks him to the floor below. He drops to the table, which makes him unconscious. Looking at him, she's about to cry. After all that, she throws her tools into the river nearby. Not long after, she calls the police. And the police see the domestic violence. They regard her actions as self-defense. Sometimes when you're facing difficulties, you don't need to give up but try to fight against it. When you are abused by your family or attacked by other people, don't forget to name them and learn how to protect yourself. Goodbye and see you later.